Hey everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome back to Tower of Guns. So, we're playing with a different gun today. Again, this one's called the Grasshopper. It's gonna be exciting. So, the Grasshopper is... arguably one of... Actually, never mind, I was gonna say arguably one of the weaker guns, especially like early on. But I guess when it comes down to it, no it's not. Actually, it does a lot of damage. Does not level as fast as some other ones, though, but it does seem to be insta-killing even green enemies, which is kind of impressive. Does seem to have arcing-ish shots. I will have to do some amount of confirmation for that kind of business, but we'll get there at some point. Anyway, let's keep going. Now, I'm trying to decide if I want to do a special run out of this. You know what? No. This gun itself is going to be special enough, if only because... of this gun's special properties, which we will get into in a little bit. If you've ever seen Men in Black, you'll kind of know what I'm talking about here. That's it, if you haven't seen Men in Black, well, you're in for a bit of a treat. Let's see, do we have enough cash for that? No. It's a speed pickup over there, and not enough money, therefore not enough speed. Now, the question of a special run was like a no-jump run, and I'm tempted, but I think I might do that... I don't know. You know what? There we go. No jump run. This is going to be interesting. I've set my jump Z down to zero, so we are going to have zero ability to jump in this run. I'm not sure how that's going to work. I might have to fly or something like that to get out of a couple of, like, awkward situations. And also, like, we're never going to be able to get to, like, half of the secrets. So I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to handle that. But, well, we're here. And we'll see what happens. Come on. So, the thing about the Grasshopper, it's supposed to explode. Hasn't exploded yet, but because it's supposed to explode, I am running around with the Major Moose, just in case. Because I believe, from what I've read and seen of the gun, it kind of will kill you very easily. Like, you'd think the Babel gun has, like, a really nice splash radius. No, this gun takes all of the cakes. There's still one. Yep, there he is. You know, for a no-jump run, I've been managing to avoid pretty much every hit, which I'm actually pretty happy about. Yep, there's the explosion that I was talking about, and I'm glad it does not do damage to me, because bad things would happen. I guess maybe it's, like, once you get up to level 3? Either way, I would love to see, like, Uber on this gun, or maybe even, Rapid would be kind of fun. Uber, Rapid, TNT would be useless, Spread would be interesting. Boy, Spread would be interesting. Actually, I have to say, Spread is probably one of my favorites, if not my absolute favorite weapon mod. Like, Uber is kind of fun, and Rapid's kind of fun, but Spread just makes everything stupid. But, if it's... not immediately obvious, this gun has really heavy kickback. Maybe not quite comparable to the old Painful, but it's getting close. It's also actually getting kind of hard to hit the big old spike room, which is kind of frustrating. But the splash damage is definitely making it do damage for us. Took some damage there. Not keen on that. Also, apparently no health pickups. Or, in fact, any pickups from the boss, which is confusing. But that's just the way things go. Okay, at least we got the health pickup. Now, realistically, since we're doing a no-jump run, I'm going to have to turn that off for when we finally fight the Maw, just because there's no way I'm going to be able to get over to the Maw without, you know, no lava damage. And seeing as there's an absolute requirement with this gun, more or less, to run Mighty Moose or you'll kill yourself, so we're going to have to be able to jump for the Maw. But everything else, I'm going to try not jumping for. And if luck will have it that we don't finish the run, well, we don't finish the run, and I don't have to, turn jumping back on just to fight one singular boss. I'm noticing that the shots kind of explode prematurely. I wonder if that's, gonna be a problem. Definitely might mean, like, limited range. Please don't take lava damage. Thank you. And... I also have half a mind to, like, cheat to get up to, like, turn on fly, if only to get up to secrets that I know about, and thus far we haven't actually gotten to any secrets that we know about that I'd be able to reach normally, I think, because the only reason- oh, shit. The only reason why I'm even remotely interested in doing a no jump, Tower of Guns run is purely because, wow, my frame rate really does not like that. Luckily, you guys can't see anything amidst all the explosions, so it kind of doesn't matter how bad the frame rate gets when I start shooting. Some of these guns. Anyway, if I see a secret area that, there's a hair in my mouth. That doesn't happen very often. Yeah, if I see a secret that I know about, and holy crap, if I know about it and, you know, can't get to it because I can't jump, I'm probably going to cheat to get over there, just because, I don't know, figure close enough, and I totally missed with that. I'm also noticing with the Grasshopper, it shoots very slowly. Like, the shot speed, the movement of it, is slow, which I didn't expect. I figured they just, like, pile driver straight across the stage, but no. Oh! Okay, they move very slowly and explode constantly. That's different. Did not expect that. If you notice, our health is a little low. We're not doing so well on the health department. Hopefully, we'll do a little bit better. But, I mean, realistically, we can't jump, so makes it kind of hard. Looks like there's another gun over there. So, you know, I'm going to, seeing as this is already a challenge enough run, I might actually fly over and get it. If it's the gun I think it is, then I'm gonna head over and grab it anyway, because, you know what, why not, we're here. But first, let's, clear the stage, because I'm not going to do the whole, like, secret thing until I have, gotten everything. Now, one sort of cool thing about this, gun, that I was kind of paying attention to, is the shots keep going, but they explode constantly as they go. So, if you notice, they kind of just pulse instead of shooting. Oh, shoot. shoot. We've got a couple of triple spin bots. Hopefully when he dies, he will, you know, just bring the stuff up the lift. Maybe? Maybe not. I don't know. Hard to say. Apparently we could walk down the lift for some reason without having to worry about the, momentum driving us backwards. Oh well. It's probably a good thing. And do we see any more enemies around here? Because I really hate to get caught with my pants down here. Nope. Fly. Again, very glad you guys probably can't read the console. Oh, it's just the shrapnel trumpet. Nah. Nah, I thought it was a completely different gun. And if it's just going to be the shrapnel trumpet, I'm not interested. Last run was very shrapnel trumpet heavy, and I'd prefer that we don't have that kind of business. And actually, back to the previous topic, if you can read the console, well, have fun. It's not like it's completely private information, but figured I'd, you know, be slightly mysterious about my cheating ways, right? Right. Okay. Lots of hot pot bots, lots of bomb bots, taking a little bit of damage here and there. Unfortunately, can't jump away, but I can walk away, come to think of it. Ooh, blue EXP. Thank you. It's probably going to get us up to weapon level something. Interestingly enough, this gun's supposed to have really crazy kickback, and I'm noticing that since we're not jumping, the kickback isn't affecting us like it normally would, which is actually kind of cool. Meaning, well, I guess the serious detractor of this gun isn't much of a detractor at all. Anyway, I think we've got, yep, a couple of, damn, that is quite the explosion, and, oh, we are in fact at weapon level 5. I was wondering about that. Anyway, let's tilt back. I don't feel like turning on fly just across a slight lava gap. And almost immediately just turned around and walked in the lava. We get item charge plus, which is kind of okay. The portable orbital laser charges really quickly from what I can tell. Like, really quickly. And I believe, oh, what's over there? Yeah, it's just a peasley little health pickup. I'll come back for it if I really need to. But I now know where the secret area is in this room. Hello. This is quite a lot of stuff. Luckily, this gun is like an insane room clearer. Only because the explosions are so large and so powerful, then it clears the entire room. I really would like to see spread mod on this gun. It would be, I think, absolutely hilarious. Anyway, sup ET gun? Eh, there are two of them. I'm so glad that, Sakuya Izoi? I think, oh god. I'm not good with, Japanese or Japanese sounding names. I'm assuming Japanese. It could be, like, Korean or something, too. Seriously, I'm not good with my, foreign nomenclature, even if it might not be 100% foreign? I don't know, I'm not gonna question it. So we got that shop, and what's this shop? Nah, don't feel like the missile swarm is really any good. Oh. Oh, maybe it's over here. I know there's a secret area in behind one of these walls. I just gotta mash my face into the right one, and then we'll get there. Unless this is a different room configuration, and then I don't even know. Hello! There we go. And that brings us down, but I don't think going down means anything. I think that's like one of the secret areas that you... You know what? Let's check. It does have a down arrow, which might mean something. Let's look. Well... anything in here? No. Anything? Oh. I see. It teleports you to the boss chamber. Well, I'm gonna fly back, just because there's that, like, whole large section of the map we haven't cleared, and it might actually have some nice loot for us. Could be wrong. Could be horribly wrong. I'm not entirely sure. But I figure we're here. Now, the other half of this run that I was considering doing, but I'm not going to do, just because it might end up, you know, leading to my own death in many other ways, is I was considering doing, this run... Oh, shoot. I was entirely unintentional and did not want to do that. Okay, where are the stairs? Gotta get back up before all the loot disappears, because unfortunately we're not running Junkman, which I would run if I could, but I can't, so this is the best we're gonna get, because... I'd very much like to have a double perk run at some point, but I don't think that's possible yet in the game. I hope Joe adds the function at some point to have, like, really crazy custom runs. Or, actually, it would be really cool if you've ever played Risk of Rain, there's, I think it's called Command Mode, where you actually get to pick what power-ups you have. That would be kind of fun to have, especially with, like, zero caps. Because it's like, oh, you want, I hear a spin bot, but I'm just going to ignore it. We didn't get really anything big there, but we didn't lose any health and we got a lot of blue EXP, so I'm going to call that good enough. Grasshopper does not level quickly. Anyway, it looks like we are fighting... Well, Lantern of Fullis. This is going to be interesting. Let's just pile off a lot of shots and see how well they wreck him. Eh. Except for the splash damage, I'd actually say this gun is pseudo-reasonable-ish. It's just a little overpowered in a lot of ways. But if I were not running Major Moose, we would already be quite dead. Quite very much dead. Anyway, did we even get an item from Lantern of Fullis? The answer is no. Maybe it fell down in the lava. That actually is possible. Nope. Didn't fall down, so I guess there was no actual drop from him. I didn't know that was possible. I thought the bosses were always supposed to drop something. But, you know, I guess this is the way it is. Okay, so let's see what's down here. The answer is health pickups, which we don't need. Curiously, after the big old spike room, we actually haven't really needed it. We have not found a whole lot of secrets, though, which is kind of a pain in the butt. I think maybe when we... What? It happened again. We skipped. That's confusing. Okay, well, this is different. So, once again, we are going into logistics first, and will not be visiting the battlements. I'm not sure how, I'm not sure why, but that's the way things go. That does mean that the difficulty level is going to be a lot lower than usual, but it also means we're probably going to be a little bit more underpowered than usual. So, I guess in the spirit of continuing this run, if we do get to the mall, maybe I'll do it in such a way that I can fly or something like that. I don't know. I don't know how I'm going to fight them all, if I'm going to fight them all, but we have, like, zero pickups, so we're kind of in this weird state of being screwed, yet somehow totally okay. I feel like my ground-based dodging skills have improved vastly since I first started this game, because I've barely gotten hit this entire run. I'm getting hit by something. Maybe it's just explosions and bullets from up there, I guess. Maybe that's what the answer is. The kickback is definitely slowing us down. I'm glad I got the extra speed pickup, though, because it's adjusting. And since I don't have any extra jumps or anything like that, I'm just going to fly up to the top of this room. I don't think it's really worth the pain of trying to get through normally. Now, there's a fair amount of blue EXP over here. I kind of want to get. But realistically, this gun does not lose a whole lot of blue EXP when it... I don't know why my, like, English skills have been, like, dropping off today. I think I'm just thinking about the future here, and it's just like, how do I do the rest of this run? Well, seeing as there's like no real possible way for me to get, well, I mean, realist, yeah, actually no, there is no way for me to get up, considering the motivational blocks. Yeah, I'm just gonna grab this. Considering the motivational blocks would, well, are unreachable if you can't jump, I'll just call this good enough. Now, I hear a bunch of stuff spawning somewhere. Hello. I'm just going to pretend I'm walking over here. And I guess realistically what I should really do is tilt back and fight them on the ground. It makes the most amount of sense. And here they are. Surprise! Oh, shoot. I forgot I still had fly on. I was just gonna walk off, fall down, and eh, good enough. It's like flying. Just, you know, or it's like walking, just more mobile, right? Holy crap, that's a lot of things. I really should just turn on walk. Walk, walk, walk. Okay, I guess my shots that I had left behind actually kind of saved us from a lot of stuff. Why are we... okay? Guess we're not walking. This is confusing? Well, I guess all the enemies are dead, so I'm not going to feel too bad about really any of this. Get all the blue EXP. I'll just kind of mash my face into here until I get all of the stuff. I think we're good, actually. I think, yeah, there's nothing else to grab, so let's go back up. That was a slow, slow process. Doesn't look like anybody else is spawning, though, so this is good. This is very good. But I'm very curious as to why walk didn't work. I'll have to check that out. Anyway, free money. Not like we've been spending it on anything, or probably will spend it on anything, but hey. Actually, come to think of it, let's spend it on something. Eh. I feel like Fly has weird momentum issues now that you, like, slide a little bit more. Which is kind of frustrating. But, oh well. Anyway, let's actually make sure we're walking again. Oh, I guess I just didn't hit enter. Duh. Let's go through the purple teleporter, look around, make sure nobody else is gonna shoot us. Looks like the answer is no. I don't think there are any secret areas in here. Could be wrong. I have been wrong about that in the past. And, ooh, looks like a super cannon. Let's see if it, yeah, portable orbital laser. Working out, I guess 90% of the time, all the time, 50, I don't know, phrases. Anyway, we've still got 8-bit launcher there, and we've got a couple of the sky cannon things. I really hope we actually run into a twerp cloud, because that would be kind of an interesting experience, I'd have to say, considering this gun would probably just rip through all of them. This is like, I would say the shrapnel trumpet's pretty good at taking out twerps, but I would say the grasshopper definitely takes the cake. I'm a little disappointed in the grasshopper, honestly. Like, it's a cool gun. Don't get me wrong about that. It's just not the gun I expected it was going to be. It's just not the man I used to love. Because what I was expecting was something a little bit more, I guess, in line with the actual movies, where the, you know, the shots move extremely fast and then explode and really kick you backwards. But in this case, it's just, I don't know, massive orby things. Which is a bit disappointing, but whatever. Ah, holy crap. There's quite a lot of stuff. I think I should just move forward and kind of hope nothing kills me while I'm doing so. Looks like actually worked out pretty well for me. I got hit in the face a couple of times, but it worked. Hope we don't have to fight the... Ooh, actually no. I bet if we ended up fighting the... I'm gonna go down the ladder. I don't know what's down there specifically. Actually, everybody's dead, so back to flying. Yeah. I don't know what would happen if we ended up fighting the Egg Scrambler. That's what I was thinking about. It's like, on one hand, it would be kind of a painful experience, potentially, considering we can't jump. But then again, I'm not entirely sure if jumping against the Egg Scrambler is even, like, that big of a deal-ish? I don't know. But, I'm curious about whether or not my shots would go directly through the shield, considering they move through anything, I think. Well, let's get the money, and what's the last secret? At this point, I'm just kind of going for all secrets that I know about, considering we missed the battlements yet again, which is weird and strange and should never happen, but I guess it did. And, like, we didn't even get the Togadrome to replace it, even though the Togadrome is kind of a poor replacement for a stage, considering it's, you know, brutally difficult. But yeah, as far as the Grasshopper goes, I kind of wish it actually behaved like the Togadrome in Hello. Oh, is this room? I wish it behaved like the grasshopper in. Oh, dear. I guess I can kind of use the kickback to prevent myself from falling, which is good. Ish. Let's use the, wow, that's a lot of tanks. let's use the motivational blocks to get us out and away from everything. Unfortunately, there's still a lot of scary going on. Taking a lot of damage. Not so great. Luckily, there's like a smorgasbord of nice and cool and useful things all over the place. I just wish there weren't mines on the ground so I could go and get them with impunity. Don't entirely know why, I just kind of flew off into the sky. Alright, this is enough screwing around trying to get stuff. Let's get over here and take out all the mines. That way, I think portable orbital laser just did us quite the favor. And we've got a couple of tanks. We've still got mines coming from somewhere. Not entirely sure. Oh, it's over there-ish? Jeez. This is rough. And apparently we also have a lot of ET guns, too. This room is not kind to me. Doesn't help that I don't have a single gosh darn armor pickup at all. Anyway, let's grab our ill-gotten gains. I don't see much up there that we really need. At this point, like, blue EXP is nice, but health pickups are truly necessary. Anyway, let's see. Don't know if I'm going to get to that one in time. Nope, did not. Okay, so we've got a couple more mine layers. I really wish they had died. I had shot at them, but I guess those grasshopper shots probably got intercepted by the tanks or something. I was going to say, I bet if I walk down here and go through the purple teleporter, I'll spawn on the level with them. Then I realized, well, the mines are all in the way. Anyway, looks like we've got... Yep, here they are. Surprise! Oh, guess portable orbital laser not actually charged yet. Did not realize that. Anyway, oh, right. I know where the secret area is in this room, too. Or at least one of them. There are, like, several. Anyway, we're taking some stupid mine damage here, but not like we can jump over them or anything, so it kind of really limits our movement. Anyway, let's get the blue EXP. There's not... I mean, we're injured, but we're not that injured, so I think we'll come out okay. But we are short one health pickup compared to what we should be at, considering we didn't go to the battlements or warehouse, and, well, there's that secret area, so let's go off to the other one. I think there are only two on this level. There could be more. I've never actually officially confirmed whether or not there are more than two secrets on this level. Anyway, I guess we're going to be hale and hearty because this is a lot of health pickups, a lot of health upgrades. Really happy about that, actually, because we've been taking quite a lot. We don't really need much for damage. This gun does a fairly sizable amount, but we do definitely need some armor because, as it stands, we're a bit flimsy. I'm pressing K, but it's not recognizing it. Maybe I'm just pressing K too close to L. What are... Oh, well, time for science! I was wondering what would happen if I fought this boss. And I guess we get to figure out. This might actually be the end of the run already. Or not. I don't know. It's interesting questions. Interesting questions. We don't have, like, I mean, our use item is pretty useful-ish. But it's not... as useful. Apparently I missed with the portable orbital laser. I have to make sure I don't get hit by any of the spinny gunk, but yeah, it looks like my shots do not hit him through the stuff. Well, this is going to be actually a serious problem. We probably will die against this boss, which is kind of a shame, because I like my special runs to actually go past the whole everything. But, like, my grasshopper shots just do not do damage, and I just took a full bar of damage from one of these spiky pillars, which is a serious problem. Oh well, I'll give it the old college try and see if I can succeed at it, but no promises, guys. No promises. I mean, we're doing a sizable amount of damage to him when we do hit. It's just a matter of if and when. Because if my shots just went through everything, this guy would probably die almost instantaneously. But matter of... Oh, shoot. I'm just getting tousled around. This is very, very bad. At this point, it's like... kill him before he kills me, or just get killed. Unfortunately, put a shield up, and this is really, really bad. Just die already. Just die. There we go. Whew, that hurt. We dropped down to, Torp Totem. Don't even need that. Okay, so let's grab as much health as we can. I'm tempted to murder some hug bots, but I know that would make things a lot harder. Even though we're about to go on to the Sanctum. I, I honestly can't believe that we actually managed to survive that. Just because the egg scrambler is usually pretty, pretty cruel mistress. Anyway, fly. What do we got over here? Armor would have made that substantially easier. That was a very Peasley secret. I am disappointed. Anyway, let's get through and go on to wherever. Because I found 72% of the secrets. That's pretty good. And that bumped us up from 9% to 40%. So we really haven't had a whole lot of secrets this entire run. Back to walking. You know, I'm pretty okay with a walk-only run. I think I have another walk-only run planned soon, sooner than later. Like, usually I don't try and mimic the special runs unless, like, something special is happening. And I think I have an idea of what I'm going to do for episode 100. But I'm not going to talk about it. Because I already did the backwards run, which I think I originally said was going to be episode 100 or something like that. And yes, it was more of like a kick backwards run, and there will be backwards flight at some point. Probably sooner than later, but I got some other ideas that I'm kind of excited about. And of course I've got that thing that I've been alluding to, even though, I mean, half of you guys have probably already seen them before. So, it's maybe not that special. Feels special to me, damn it. Anyway, fly. God, it just sounds like I was alluding to putting up a dick pic or something. That would be embarrassing. Okay, seeing as that gun is pretty much charged, let's charge up the Babel gun, which barely charges at all. Don't need the difficulty +++, and back to walking. I like the gun. It doesn't fit my expectations here. So I was expecting, oh shoot. Actually no, this is probably the best gun for this specific type of enemy and specific type of room. I guess the only other exception I could think of would be like the shrapnel trumpet would be pretty damn good against these guys. If it's not immediately obvious amongst all the explosions, there are a bunch of the invisible laser guys. Oh, God, stuck in a ramp. That was bad. You know, for a no-jump run, this is actually working out pretty well. I'm pretty happy with how much we haven't died yet. The egg scrambler was a bit of a concern, but it wasn't actually as hard as I thought it was going to be. Anyway, we've got this guy over here. I'm just going to use the portable orbital laser because I really don't want to deal with the shots. And no more health. Oh, some health. Good. Need that. And Bluey XP. Okay, what do we got over there? I think that's actually another special gun, come to think of it. Yeah, it is. It's the smoke launcher, I believe. Nope. What? Ha! Is that really... I just found the grasshopper when I summoned the grasshopper as a cheat code. That's hilarious. So yeah, now I just have the grasshopper. It's the first time I've ever actually found it in the wild, quote-unquote. I, you know, summoned this one up just like all the other ones. But, Well, that would have been interesting, actually finding the grasshopper. Okay, so we've got a lot of pain, a lot of sadness in here. But hopefully we can, just kind of take them out without actually having to tango with them. Looks like that's the case. We've got cannons galore, so I want to kind of be wary of that. Dodge shots if I can. Main goal is going to be not lose health, go figure, but primarily seeing if I can get through and get as many health pickups as possible. Okay, so we've killed pretty much everything except for you. Now we've killed you, and we're good. So did he drop something good for us? The answer is ish. I was hoping for more health, but take what I can get. So we're 2.5 bars shy of full health. And let's fly over the secret area. Flyu. Sounds like some really crappy otaku trying to say fly in Japanese and failing miserably at it. And it's another difficulty -. Hey, can't complain about this, especially because we're going to need it, because Gumball Machine is notoriously dickish to people that can't jump. In fact, come to think of it, this entire run, I've only ever gotten one jump, like one extra jump, and no jump height. This has been actually a really low power run as far as like drops go. Most of the enemies have been dropping like useless stuff like item charge, which I guess is nice for the portable orbital laser, but isn't as nice as some other circumstances. Like, I've had fantastic runs. I'm thinking back to Endless Mode with the 6 to 9 millimeter hand cannon. Now that was a run. This run's been pretty lackluster. I wonder if my shots will splash damage through his shield. The answer is yes. Oh wow, that's gonna make this easy. Potentially. Okay, we've got a lot of stuff around us, but I'm doing damage to him, which is great. I don't know if the secondary shield's gonna... Nope, apparently I can just hit him regardless of where I am in the room, which is great, because I really don't want to stand still, and I really don't want to, like, try and aim for specific stuff. Suck it. Gumball machine, I got your number. It's 585, I'm a wuss. I'm just going to kill him with splash damage through his shields. This is kind of the best. Oh, maybe he's not actually... Maybe the inner shield is now blocking it. Well, whatever. Let's just take him out. The old-fashioned-y way of just continuing to rotate around, because we're not actually taking much damage here. And, you know, the splash damage is taking him out. It's just a matter of getting that shield down just for a little bit, because it's the inner one that's the thing blocking him from taking damage. We're not actually taking that much, so circle strafing across the entire room actually working out very well for us, because the kickback isn't slowing us down. It's actually making it a little bit easier to dodge. We just have to get him down. Come on, die. He is not dying. We are losing health here, which is kind of bad. But it's only going to be like a couple more hits before he goes down. And luckily, since this gun has such a crazy kickback, and also slow shots, when the shields go down, my shots are moving through. The problem is, well, still not a good position to be in. Just die. He's almost dead. Yeah, he got a lot harder now that the fact that I can't hit him through his shields. Because this gun, not actually adequately equipped for this situation. Come on. Just a couple more hits. Unfortunately, the way the shield works is my shots pulse at the wrong time, so it never hits him. This is going to be really bad. Like, he's almost dead, too. And that's unfortunate. He's, like, seriously, almost dead. Interestingly enough, I've cleared the stage pretty much of, like, every enemy. We just have to make sure we don't get killed by any of them. We're getting hit here and there, but he's almost gone. I think it's the spiky balls that are really wrecking our shit right now. Oh, this is really bad. Come on, just a couple of pulses. He's dead. Whew. And is that the caffeinated trigger finger? You know what? That's going to be a heck of a lot better than the thing we had. Because as much as the portable orbital laser is nice, well, it's not that good. Anyway, I'm incredibly impressed that we even got this far. Time to murder every Hugbot in existence. Magnetism would really help in this situation. And we're back up to full health. Back up to max weapon level, pretty much. There we go. And yeah, max weapon level on both. I'm going to avoid using the Babel Gun unless I absolutely have to. But, well, if I absolutely have to, I absolutely have to. Time to go fight the Maw. And I guess it's time to turn on fly mode at long last. Because there's no way I'm fighting the Maw groundbound. He would just murder me in the face. The stage is too tiny. I mean, sure, if I was a lava walker, it wouldn't be a problem. But, yeah. Also, apparently that was 100% of the secrets in that level. So that means Sanctum really doesn't have a whole lot. But then again, really hasn't had a whole lot in the past either. So our difficulty is going to be a bit higher. Oh, no, did I fly? Okay, so I guess going through the stage just reset my thing. So jump Z doesn't get reset, but fly and walk and whatnot will get reset depending on whatever run you're on. Interesting. I've never actually messed around with that. I was kind of hoping I could go down without the like lift going down or something like that. Should figure out where the secret is in the crow's nest, because I actually know there is one. Because when we finish the stage, currently we're at 48% secrets found, and it's probably going to go down to like 46 or 47 or something like that, because I remember the last time we came through, there was actually a secret area, I believe. Anyway, let's go see about the Maw. I wonder if I could just like get through the teleporter. No! Guess you have to, like, cheat somehow to get through that one. I wonder if we've actually managed to get that before. Anyway, I'm just gonna fire off a bunch of shots, just because it's going to make it, incredibly easy if they're all lined up. That caffeinated trigger finger really, actually, realistically, I probably should have done that, like, a long... Oh, no. They don't have the range to hit him. Oh, this is a problem. I guess we're gonna have to do the thing I said I wasn't going to do. But, the grasshopper just... Shit. The grasshopper just does not have the range to hit the maw in this circumstance. I did not expect that would happen. Unfortunately, we're already down to weapon level 3 with this gun, and that means slow going. Maybe if I kill some super cannons. God damn, this gun doesn't do a whole lot of damage in comparison to grasshopper. Anyway, I think we're gonna do okay. Fly is usually a pretty ridiculous beast as far as everything goes. The other reason why I'm doing this is because it's going to make it a heck of a lot easier to caffeinate a trigger finger a second time around. Because I think what I'm going to do is, once it's fully charged, you know what? Grasshopper, probably better hopper. Ooh, and maybe we'll be able to hit him in this circumstance. Please hit the fan? No? And apparently even fly. Yeah, no. Like one of my grasshopper shots hit him there. That sucks. And now we're getting shot by the bullet stuff, which kind of sucks. We might not actually win this round, if only because the technical limitations in the grasshopper make it impossible to do so. I was not actually expecting that. I was like, hey, this is just going to be an interesting run. And, well, maybe this is going to be my Hail Mary right now. Oh, we got him. Okay, so apparently flying directly at him, well, he's in fan mode, and caffeinated trigger fingering the crap out of him was the only thing that saved us there. We lost almost all of our health in that kind of random blitz. Glad I did it, though, because, well, it would have been a shame to get this far and not win. Glad this is not on endless mode. I do not like the grasshopper. It's an okay gun, but it sucks against bosses. Like, the egg scrambler, it had trouble getting through the shield because of how the pulses work. What the heck? Does it normally make this noise? Weird. Oh! I get it. Okay, so, we're slowly floating towards the top of the screen. So what's happened is, since I have jump C at 0, it's all kind of screwed up. So instead of doing the usual up and down thing, we're just floating up and jumping infinitely. That's a weird bug that I did not expect, but kind of hilarious. I like that. I clearly should mess with the game physics some more. I think we'll do a slow-mo run soon. I don't know if it'll be, like, slowed-down time or sped-up time. I think if I do a slowed-down time run, it'll have to be, like, live-streamed, which is kind of a problem because I don't have good enough internet for that, I think. But, you know, could be interesting anyway. I like that run. I'm never using the grasshopper again if I get the choice, because it's not... Like, it's great for room clearing, but it's just too slow. Yep. So there's actually a secret in the crow's nest. I'll have to go find that at some point. Anyway, that was a great run. I was not expecting us to do as well as we did. If we had been on, you know, walk mode for the maw, we never would have made it. The grasshopper was just, like, almost completely useless for it, because the shots would explode before getting there. And it's just like, well, this is... a serious problem. Anyway, let's see how we did. Yeah, also, serious problem. The number of pickups we got. If I hadn't cheated there, we would have had, like, maybe half of those and would have been in pretty extreme dire straits. That was a really good run. I'm pretty happy with it overall. Terrible loot. Caffeinated trigger finger saved our butts at the very, very end of the game. Babblegun probably could have helped too if I hadn't accidentally de-leveled it twice, just as we were going into that fight. Jump height, 0. Number of extra jumps, 2. Pointless. But seriously, we had, like, nothing. Anyway, I will see you guys on the next run of Tower of Guns, and it will be a new special gun, and it will be maybe a new challenge, maybe not. I'm kind of running out of ideas. This is, what, episode 94? And we still got, you know, 95, 96, 97, 98, and then... 99 and 100. So I'm gonna have to get a little bit creative here. I might do an all gun run and I just roll the mouse wheel and then pick from there. Actually, yeah, I'm gonna do that at some point. The only problem is I'm gonna need to figure out how to get blue EXP up the wazoo. So I'll have to experiment with that. Maybe it'll be like a Taco Terror run. Actually, that'd be kind of terrifying considering how many of these guns have like really awful splash damage. It might have to be another Major Moose run. Anyway, So, I'll see you guys then, and as always, thanks for watching.